I want us to talk about or think about a very important aspect about the birth of Jesus and then basically ask one question. The most important thing for us about the birth of Jesus is that this was God incarnate. So the question, one singular question that I want us to consider this Christmas day is, why would God need to become a man? Why the incarnation? And why come as a feeble human being? Why couldn't God show up as God? And then why a gruesome cross? I mean, could he not have done it some less gruesome way? Hey, what about before and after? He died in time. So what about people before? And what about people after? You and me living 2,000 years ago. How can it impact me today? How can it impact you today? What about other people groups? Other groups of people? What about them having their incarnation of God? Would that be necessary? And then what about if he came back then, does he need to keep coming over and over and over again in time? Does he need to incarnate multiple times? So, in answering this one question, why would there be a need for God to incarnate? So let's start at the very beginning, or maybe before. Before the beginning, there was God. In the mind of God, the Bible reveals to us that everything was already finished before he even started. So now we come to the beginning. So in the beginning, God created everything. And so we understand from scriptures that man and woman, Adam and Eve, they sinned, disobeyed God. And then came in all the consequences of sin. Sin separates us from God. Sin coming in through one man passed upon the entire human race, from all those who were born after that. Ultimately, the Bible says that the result of sin is death. And so this is where the incarnation comes in. Now, I want to bring your attention to four reasons why the incarnation is necessary. Number one, he had to become man to reveal God to us. I got to communicate with these people. The only way I can speak to them is become like one of them. The Bible says that this Jesus who was born, he is the image of the invisible God. The second reason that God had to become a man, the incarnation had to take place, was he had to become a man to demonstrate what we were originally designed to live like. The third reason he had to become a man is so that he could represent man. The first man, Adam, representing the entire human race, sold the entire human race in subjection to the devil. Now he had to represent you and me on our behalf, go back to Satan and say, I'm canceling what Adam signed. But he also represented you and me before God. Here was a priest, the Bible says, who could represent us fully before God and yet be our intercessor because he also knew what we felt like. And the last one, number four, why did he have to become a man? He became a man to be our perfect substitute. Now, none of us can atone even for our own sins, forget for the sins of the others. So we need somebody sinless. And such a man could only come if God became a man. So we'll just go back very quickly to some of the questions we asked at the beginning and then close. So why did he have to come as a feeble human being? Because all these four things he could only do as a human being. In order to represent God to man, to speak our language, he had to confine himself to a human body. He had to reveal God to us. He had to demonstrate to us, living in a human body, what man was originally designed to live as. As a human person, he could represent us before God and against the devil. And as a human person, he could be our substitute. But why a gruesome cross? First of all, God had to be consistent with his own nature. A second reason why the cross was necessary is because forgiveness is never cheap. Third reason why the cross was so necessary is true love is always substitutionary. What about before and after? So when Jesus Christ died on the cross, took care of everything before everything ever to come. What about other groups of people? God comes once, he comes among a people, but he came for the whole world. The last question, would God need to incarnate multiple times? The reason for the incarnation was to reveal, to demonstrate, to represent, and to be the perfect substitute. And there's one thing he invites you and me to do. He says, repent, believe, and follow.